I'm here at Brandon Artemisia Reserve in the United Kingdom. It's just an eighth of a hectare. It's most famous as being the main UK location for the field wormwood, but also having wormwood, moonshiner beetle, and other rare species. The problem with small sites is they have small populations, which may go extinct. And they also experience more edges. And with edges, species may wander off, or they might get run over, or there might be pollution or invasives, etc. And biologists have worked out how big sites need to be in order to be viable. And it depends partly on the home range. So for wild dogs, they require at least 3,000 square kilometers, while silver-spotted skipper butterflies just require a tenth of a hectare. And it's more complicated than that. It also depends on an interaction between area and isolation. So if a site is small, it will go extinct. If a site is isolated, it won't get colonized. But if it's small but connected, the site might get colonized, go extinct, but get colonized again, and thus be viable. And this interaction between area and isolation is critical. So many of our conservation problems are that sites are getting smaller or poorer quality or more isolated. In 2010, a number of us were asked to write a report for the government on what a resilient ecological network would look like. This was ably led by John Lawton. And the principles we came up with is that we needed a network consisting of more, better, larger, and more joined up sites. And those seven words have become known as the Lawton Principles, and that they derive much of UK nature conservation. And they're based on this science that I've described on the effect of habitat size, edge effects, and isolation.